Hey, so let's talk about the Thyroid Reset Diet. Here's a good overview of it, what it is, why it works, why it matters. The short version is that this is a clinically proven way to reverse thyroid disease for most people. That's a big, bold statement. I wouldn't say that there wasn't good evidence for that. Multiple studies have shown that between 60% of people can fully reverse thyroid disease within 3 months by following these guidelines. And they're simple. Their main goal is the regulation of iodine. They also cover other bases that help improve thyroid function. Now, that's 60 to 80%, that's great, right? Well, of the remaining, 40 to 20%, many of those people didn't get to a low enough iodine window, or they didn't do it long enough. They were improving, but they weren't yet fully normal. So if we rephrase things and say, of those who follow guidelines and get to a target, how many reverse thyroid disease or get close to it or radically improve thyroid function? The answer to that is 95 to 97%. So nearly everyone who does this sees some big benefit. And this is harmless. It's not extreme. It's not crazy restrictive. There's a few foods that are really high in iodine, but they're easy to work around. And there's substitutes that allow you to eat those same categories of foods. So you're not deprived, you're not starved, it's not extreme, it's not weird, but it's effective. It's very effective, and I'm super happy to share this with you guys. So iodine regulation, you know, this is odd. At a superficial level, you could think, but your thyroid needs iodine. And it does, it needs it. And it's not about it being the bad guy. It's not about wanting it gone or banishing it from the kingdom or getting rid of it. It's about being in a certain window. So the thyroid reset talks about a reset phase, and that's a window of below 100 micrograms. That's done short-term to reverse thyroid disease. Might be 3, 6, 12 months, but once you've seen thyroid disease stable and correct, you're good. You don't need to do that long-term. But it does encourage a maintenance phase, and that's what you can do longer-term. That allows between about 50 and 200 micrograms per day. Now, here's the thing. You aren't going to see the amount of iodine on food labels. You won't even find many helpful lists online, not any thorough ones. And there's not great tests to do on a regular basis for tracking your iodine. That's why the Thyroid Reset Diet broke things down into green, yellow, and red light foods. Super easy. During the reset, you stick to green light foods. Once you have undergone your reset, you can optionally throw in up to 2 servings of yellow light foods per day. That's as hard as it gets. So once you learn those, you can work around that. Now, there's other ways in which your diet affects your thyroid, macronutrient balance, other important micronutrients, certain good food categories. The Thyroid Reset Diet takes all of that stuff into account for you, so you don't have to do the hard work on that. Now, this was motivated, the study came about, because we've known forever that a massive overdose of iodine can trigger thyroid disease. We've recently learned that the people genetically prone to thyroid disease, and it is genetic, if you are an identical twin that has thyroid disease, your twin has a 79% chance of getting it. It's strongly genetic. But the genes that affect it are genes of iodine metabolism. So you can control how those work by controlling your iodine intake. There's a safe range of between 50 and 200 micrograms that you can easily stay within and keep things stable and keep things from going wrong. The Thyroid Reset Diet guides you through that. And it's effective, it's tasty, it's good foods, and you can do it. So the story was that thyroid disease in the US was rare before iodine fortification. Once that started in 1924, the rates of thyroid disease amongst women in their 30s and 40s went up 25,000-fold. Not making that up, it became very common. And it's continued to grow since then. And we've seen that every place in the world that's fortified with iodine has had the same thing emerge. Now, they keep doing it because it does help kids get less goiter. That's true. But there's been this increase of adult thyroid disease that's correlated with it. And this goes on in other ways that make sense. The Japanese have the highest iodine intake overall. Not a coincidence that a Japanese doctor discovered the cause of autoimmune thyroid disease because they have the most of it, Dr. Hiroko Hashimoto. They also have the highest rates of thyroid cancer and Graves' disease. And we see this correlation across the world in adults. So yeah, we don't have iodine deficiency. And some places have overt iodine excess. In the United States, about 30 to 40% of the population is exposed to amounts above 200 micrograms per day. And it's easy to do that. There's a lot of it in things like pink Himalayan salt or sea salt. Even if it's not fortified, it's still there. There's a ton of it in supplements. It's not well regulated or controlled. We can get a lot of it in personal care products. And if you're prone to be sensitive, you can easily get too much. But the cool thing is you can identify those and you can get to that low level and usually reverse that. So that's the overview. The Thyroid Reset Diet walks you through this. It tells you how to do the reset stage, how long to do that, how to know what to test for, when you can move back into the maintenance stage, and what to do if you're on medication. If you are, your body can do better with the medication by regulating iodine, because there's iodine in the meds as well. So this is a great opportunity to reverse the disease, to lower symptoms, lower your burden of medication. It even helps for those with Graves' disease. It even helps those who lack a thyroid. So super important, very effective. And I spent so much time looking at medical literature on all things diet and thyroid disease. There's a lot of ideas and theories, and there's about 20,000 good studies on this iodine association. There's only a few handfuls of studies on all other ways that diet can affect your thyroid, but this is the one that matters the most, and this can reverse this. All right, Dr. C with you. Take great care.